Introductory briefing. Lieutenant Surge? He's loud, tough, and has a no-nonsense attitude. And all we ever hear about him is about the war. The theoretic Kanto war that explains various bits in the Gen 1 games.
Like why you don't have a dad, and why most people are either very young or very old.
But that's just a thing.
But no, there's bound to be more to Lieutenant Surge than just that, right? Like, did you know that he goes by the title of Lightning Lieutenant? Wait. Doesn't sound right.
Aha, here we go. Did you know that he goes by the title of Lightning American?
It wouldn't even be the first time that real-world geographic locations are mentioned in Pokemon. We also see references to South America, India, heck, Kanto is literally the name of the region in Japan, Kanto. Kanto is based on Kanto, jeez. The Pokemon world is very much just our own world, but with differences in name and scale. America clearly exists in Pokemon, but New York is called Unova. Hawaii is called Alola, and Arizona is called Orre. And come to think of it, which of these, if any, would Lieutenant Surge be from? Well, I guess we'll go through them and find out, huh? Because that's this video. Cue the intro.
Jingle balls, wait a minute, that's not the song. No, it is, because today's video is brought to you by Manscaped. It's the holiday season, time for gifts. Santa gives Mrs. Claus the same gift every year.
Fresh.
Oh my.
It may not age you backwards, but back hair be gone. Manscaped's Lawnmower 4.0 waterproof cordless trimmer has advanced skin-safe technology, which helps reduce nicks and cuts on your most sensitive areas. So goodbye, body hair! And it has this cool LED light, which is really helpful for grooming on those cold, dark winter nights. I'm sure Santa keeps those bells shiny with their crop preserver and ball deodorant. And he keeps those nails real nice with Manscaped's luxury 6-piece stainless steel nail kit, the nicest nail trimmers I've ever used, honestly. And Manscaped's got 2 free gifts for you right now, the Shed Travel Bag and the Manscaped Anti-Chafing Boxer Briefs. So much gift! So give that special man in your life a special gift. And maybe that special man is you, because self-love is important. Don't wait! Go to manscaped.com and use my promo code LOCKSTIN20 to get 20% off plus free international shipping plus 2 free gifts! Your jingle balls will thank you. I bet Lieutenant Surge Manscapes.
To be or not to be.
Get it, Orre spelled with an extra RE at the end, so it's the Orre region. I hope you get that. But right off the bat, we're going to eliminate the Orre region from our list of choices. Okay, now I'm sure some of you want to know why we can't count your favorite region. Well, I hate to break it to you, but there's absolutely nothing even remotely related to Lieutenant Surge. There's also the fact that this was part of a side series of games and not the main series, which typically puts it into non-canon territory to the people who care about that kind of thing. Sorry, guys. Now, Arceus bless Unova, because that's the next place we're looking into. Now, you'd think that this being the first region in the main series that's based off of America, there would be some sign or reference to Lieutenant Surge somewhere, right? Well, let's take a closer look. We have Mistralton City. It features an airport and an airfield, so we can connect that to Lieutenant Surge, knowing how to fly planes and all, which, come to think of it, would place him more so in the Air Force and not the Army like the game suggests, since the Army hasn't flown planes since 1947. Well, the only aircraft the Army pilots these days are helicopters and drones. But there's also the nearby Chargestone Cave, and hey, that has electric Pokemon. How convenient. Speaking of electric types, there's also an electric type gym in Mimbasa City. And with all of that, surely that must mean Lieutenant Surge is from Unova, right? Well, unfortunately, that doesn't seem to be the case, because while it would make perfect sense for there to be something here, a nod, a reference, an homage of some kind, even just a mention, but there's nothing concrete here either. As for Mimbasa City, we can't be certain if an electric-type gym has always been a thing in Unova, or if it's a recent development. As we see in Black 2 and White 2, some gyms retire, and other ones can be made. Who knows how long Elisa's gym has been around, or even if she's always been the gym leader, or just took over from someone else. Was that person electric-type? Who knows? And there's also another glaring strike against Unova being Lieutenant Surge's home region, and that's the Pokemon World Tournament. Or rather, what is both said and not said during the tournament. What do I mean by this? Well, when you participate in the World Leaders Tournament and just so happen to have Lieutenant Surge as your opponent, well, according to Bulbapedia, the tournament announcer will question if he's even from Unova, as in at all. Assuming it is right, that could still be some evidence of what we're trying to piece together. Why wouldn't Lieutenant Surge be bragging about defending his country or his region on which he currently stands? This is my home territory, I'm gonna beat you up good. But no, he doesn't. Even though that's a point of pride that many military types have, especially in media depictions. And even after beating Lieutenant Surge in any of the tournaments, if you talk to him in the lobby, he still makes no mention of his thoughts of being in Unova at all. You'd think he'd say something. Well, come on, Lieutenant. Instead, all of his dialogue is extremely generic. It's almost like Game Freak added these characters for fun without any regard for their story. No, yeah, that's gotta be it. Gameplay and Easter eggs over lore. Always. Pokemon is no stranger to that. I mean, come on, they even have Giovanni participating in the tournament too. What are you even doing here, man? You are internationally wanted.
Anyway, that leaves us with one option left. The Alola region. Alola, oi, until we meet again.
So what does Alola have that Orre and Unova don't?
Well, the only thing that matters. References to the big man himself.
This comes in two forms, a signed autograph from the lieutenant, and a tourist trap dedicated to his gym. At the beginning of the Gen 7 games, when you explore the player character's room, you find a framed photograph signed by Lieutenant Surge. If we take Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee into account, these autographs are given as an additional reward to trainers who beat him, along with his Thunder Badge. Now, clearly, this wasn't given to the player character as a reward since they don't start their Pokemon journey until after they move to Alola, so perhaps this was a souvenir then? Notably, it is mentioned that you recently moved here from Kanto, and on the picture it says, good luck. So someone had to have told Lieutenant Surge about the move, right? Or about you starting your Pokemon journey soon? Is he a friend of the family? Perhaps with a shared background? Maybe these friends of his moving to Alola is meaningful to him, as Alola holds a special place in his heart because maybe he's from there? Bit of a stretch, but maybe it's supplementary. The next thing to address is, of course, the Kantonian gym located in Miley City. One of the most blatant tourist traps you'll ever see. For the low price of 1,000 Poké Dollars, you too can take on the
Kantonian
City Gym and earn the coveted Surge Badge. Now, you want to know the funny part about all this? The fact that they have to call it the Kantonian Gym and the Surge Badge means that there's some sort of international copyright law that they are trying not to violate. So they have to make it legally distinct right down to changing how the Surge Badge looks. The Pokemon League uses copyright, and that's funny to me. Do you think Lieutenant Surge set all this up? But because he works for the Pokemon League, who own the IP of that badge and gym name and everything, he still couldn't use those names? Notably, Surge's partner Pokemon is a Raichu, which also happened to be quite popular in Alola, albeit in a different form. Perhaps in moving to Kanto, he fell in love with the Kantonian Raichu because they reminded him of home. This all would be very quite fitting thematically as well. One of the biggest contributing factors to making Hawaii a state was its location. It's a very good place for military bases, and likewise, Japan is covered with American military bases set up immediately after World War II. Perhaps that's what the Kantonian War is referencing. Well, I guess for now there's nothing extremely solid, but all evidence currently points primarily to Lieutenant Surge being Alolan. So what do you think about this theory? It's a very loose theory, so it's a theory for sure, or a hypothesis I guess technically. But what do you think? Is Lieutenant Surge Alolan? Let me know down below, and until next time, never stop using your noggin. Gosh, geez.